When you're raised as a Baptist in North Carolina, you don't know what the word Lent is. I promise you, I never heard it until I was a junior in high school, and that was because I took a job as organist and choir master in a Methodist church. When I got to college, I began to read and understand more about what Lent was and what keeping a fast was, and so I kind of went overboard. There was one year that I gave up meat for Lent, and on Fridays in that same Lent, I fasted totally, not even water. I was told later that was not smart. I usually make a silly joke about I'm giving up my spare time for Lent. It's not that much of a joke on occasion. So what I'm going to take on this Lent is contacting people, either by a note, perhaps a phone call, people that are important to me that maybe I haven't talked to as much as I should, or that I need to talk to, just to make sure we're all right, not just in Lent, but in this time of pandemic. I hope that makes sense to you. I'm still working it out myself.
I'm getting creative with my fast this year, and I'm choosing to take on a spiritual practice that will help me grow closer to God. And so our bodies are beautiful gifts from God, and often I neglect that fact as I go about my day-to-day, especially during this COVID season. I've found it really hard to get up, to get moving, to be active, to eat healthy, and so this Lent season, I am really hunkering down and focusing on this beautiful gift that God has given me. And so I invite you to join me in a fast that includes exercise each day and eating healthier. And so this is a different way to fast, but it's a fast nonetheless, because in doing these things, it helps us to remember that our bodies are beautiful gifts from God, and it helps us to grow closer to God throughout these 40 days. And so join me in this fast, a different kind of fast, as we approach Lent this season.